Einstein's theory of relativity, which has been confirmed by countless experiments, tells us that no signal capable of carrying information can move through the universe faster than the speed of light. This speed is seen as the ultimate limit of the universe, governing everything from the movement of planets to the flow of time itself. It is a rule that seems unbreakable, but then comes quantum entanglement, a phenomenon that appears to challenge this very rule. Imagine two particles becoming so deeply connected that their states are linked no matter the distance between them. We're not talking about just a small distance. These particles could be on opposite sides of the universe, yet they remain mysteriously linked. The question of whether quantum entanglement is faster than the speed of light has staggering implications. Could this phenomenon enable faster-than-light communication, reshaping technology as we know it? Or does it hint at an underlying reality governed by principles far stranger than our current models of physics can explain? Let's take a closer look. Quantum entanglement is a phenomenon in quantum physics, where two or more particles become interconnected in such a way that the state of one particle is directly related to the state of another, no matter the distance between them. When particles are entangled, a change in one particle's state will instantaneously affect the other, even if they are light years apart. This phenomenon, which left even Albert Einstein baffled, was famously dubbed spooky action at a distance. At first glance, it's tempting to think of these particles as if they were two distinct objects with predetermined characteristics. Imagine a pair of shoes, one black and one white. No matter how far apart you place these shoes, their colors remain unchanged because those colors are inherent properties of each shoe. This analogy reflects what physicists call local realism, the idea that particles have set local properties independent of observation, and that no influence or information can travel faster than the speed of light. However, quantum particles don't play by the same rules as shoes. In the quantum world, particles exist in a strange state known as superposition, where they don't have definite properties until they are measured. In this state, a particle isn't simply black or white. Instead, it hovers in a delicate balance, potentially being either both or something else entirely. The act of measurement forces the particle to choose a state, collapsing the superposition into one definite outcome. Now, when two particles become entangled, their superposition doesn't just apply to each individual particle. It stretches across both particles, binding them together in an intimate quantum connection, no matter how far apart they are. So, when you measure the state of one entangled particle, you instantly determine the state of the other. If the first particle is found to be black, the second, perhaps millions of light years away, will immediately be white, and vice versa. This instantaneous connection between entangled particles creates the illusion that information is being transmitted faster than the speed of light, violating one of the most fundamental principles of Einstein's theory of relativity. However, in reality, no information is actually traveling between the particles. Let me explain. The reality of quantum entanglement is more nuanced. The key lies in understanding what is meant by information. In the case of entangled particles, the connection between them does not involve the direct transmission of information in the conventional sense. Instead, the entangled particles are part of a single unified system, and their properties are not individually determined until one is measured. At that point, the state of the entire system becomes known. This does not mean that information is traveling from one particle to another faster than light. Rather, the particles share a correlation that exists outside the usual constraints of space and time. The entangled state of the particles is a reflection of a deeper, non-local reality, where the concept of distance becomes less meaningful. The particles are not communicating across space. They are exhibiting a connection that transcends it. Non-locality, as this phenomenon is called, suggests that entangled particles are not separate entities interacting across space, but are instead part of a single, inseparable whole. This challenges the classical view of particles as distinct objects with well-defined properties. In the quantum world, particles exist in a state of probability, described by a wave function that only collapses into a definite state when measured. Entanglement takes this concept to an even more perplexing level, where the properties of one particle are directly tied to those of another, regardless of the distance between them. This interconnectedness implies that the universe, at its most fundamental level, may be far more unified and interconnected than we typically imagine. The traditional boundaries of space and time, which seem so clear and absolute in our everyday experiences, begin to blur and dissolve in the quantum realm. The particles are not sending signals back and forth. Instead, they are part of a shared existence, a single quantum state that spans the cosmos. As experiments have shown, entangled particles do indeed exhibit correlations that cannot be explained by any classical mechanism. These correlations have been confirmed in countless tests, most famously in the Bell tests, which ruled out any hidden variables or underlying classical explanations for the observed quantum behavior. The results have consistently supported the idea that quantum mechanics, with all its strange and counterintuitive predictions, accurately describes the fundamental nature of reality. This raises profound implications for our understanding of reality. Quantum mechanics has already shown that the act of observation plays a crucial role in determining the outcome of a measurement. The observer is not just a passive witness, but an active participant in the unfolding of quantum events. In the case of entanglement, this suggests that the connection between particles is not just a physical one, but may also involve the observer's role in bringing the quantum state into being. But observation in quantum mechanics is a tricky concept. It doesn't necessarily require a conscious observer, but rather an interaction with the environment that causes the quantum system to decohere or lose its superposition state, collapsing into a specific outcome. This process is non-reversible and marks the point at which quantum possibilities become classical realities. Importantly, this collapse is local. It happens where the measurement occurs, and it doesn't involve sending any signal across space. Therefore, while the result of one measurement can be instantaneously correlated with the result of another, no information has traveled between the two points. Here's another way to look at it. When you measure a particle's state in a quantum entanglement scenario, the outcome is random, and this randomness is inherent to quantum mechanics. However, if you try to force or set a specific state on one of the entangled particles, you effectively interfere with the entanglement, breaking the correlation between the two particles. This break in entanglement means that the second particle is no longer instantaneously correlated with the first, thus preventing any information from being transmitted faster than the speed of light. The key point is that entanglement itself doesn't allow for controlled communication, because any attempt to force a state on one particle destroys the entanglement and the potential for using it to send information. This ensures compliance with the principle that no information can travel faster than the speed of light. This brings us to an important distinction: correlation versus causation. In the classical world, if one event causes another, there is usually a signal or some form of communication that carries the effect from the cause. This communication takes time, limited by the speed of light. In the quantum world, however, the correlation between entangled particles does not imply that one particle's state causes the other's state. Instead, both states are simply part of a single, non-separable system. The instant correlation observed when one particle is measured is not due to a message sent from one particle to the other, but because the two particles are components of the same quantum entity. So, what does this mean for the idea of faster-than-light communication using quantum entanglement? Simply put, it is impossible. Even though the entangled particle states are correlated instantaneously, this correlation cannot be used to transmit information from one location to another faster than light. Quantum entanglement, therefore, is not about sending messages across vast distances in no time. It is about understanding the deep, non-local connections that exist in the quantum realm, connections that defy our everyday experiences of space and time.